Hi, everyone, and welcome back to the Studio Classroom Coffee Corner. Let's continue learning about Alexandra Nechita.
Right, we've been learning that her first or her early artwork that she did looked a lot like Pablo Picasso's.
You know, and I have to be honest with you, I'm not sure, at least for me, that that's a good thing. Because I've seen some of Picasso's artwork, and it really looks strange.
Well, Kirby, I think I have to agree with you. But you know what? A lot of people love Picasso's work. And he certainly gave us another way to look at the world, didn't he?
That's
you know,
true.
It's really interesting, though, because she was painting like Picasso and had never even seen anything Picasso had painted.
That's really amazing if you think about it. And another amazing thing that I can think of is that she had her first art exhibition at 8 years old.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Well, let's learn more about this amazing woman. We're still on the same page. Join us on line 18 in the left-hand column.
Within a year, Alexandra had several other exhibitions. By then, she had completed more than 250 paintings. Her exhibition at the prestigious Mary Paxson Gallery brought her to the attention of national art critics. She began to appear on national television across America. The art world adored little Alexandra Nechita and her Picasso-like paintings. But she didn't consider herself different from other children. I am like all other kids, except that I choose to paint in my free time, she said.
We learned a moment ago that she had her exhibition at a local library at 8 years of age. Now at 9, it says, within a year, Alexandra had several other exhibitions. So this thing started to pick up speed very quickly, didn't it?
And part of the reason it did is that she was producing a lot of paintings. It said by then she had completed 250 of these paintings, and that's, I mean, it's incredible that she could paint that much.
That's right. Her exhibition at the prestigious Mary Paxson Gallery brought her to the attention of national art critics. So because they exhibited her art at the Mary Paxson Gallery, some attention was drawn to her talent.
Now, usually when we think about a gallery, we do think about a place where paintings are displayed or exhibited, don't we?
Yeah, and this particular gallery is very prestigious. And that just means that it's greatly respected and admired, usually because it's pretty important.
Mm-hmm. So this place is very important for artists, mm-hmm. and to have her work actually exhibited there was a wonderful thing for a 9-year-old.
That's right. That word prestigious is quite large, and maybe we should review it together with this conversation.
This is a prestigious neighborhood.
It doesn't look very prestigious to me. It looks quite ordinary.
Oh, yes, it's prestigious. Rich and important people live here.
Maybe I should move into this neighborhood then.
Why? Are you rich?
No, but I'm pretty important.
Oh, yeah? Who thinks you're important?
My family!
Because her work was at this prestigious gallery, she had the attention of national art critics. Now, sometimes we think of critics as people that just say bad things about other people, but actually, critics are also people that are paid to give their opinions on things like movies or mm-hmm. books and pieces of art as well.
And it looks like the critics liked her. It says that she began to appear on national television across America. So TV that can be seen by the whole nation in America, they were able to see her on it.
And notice it says the art world adored this little Alexandra Nechita and her Picasso-like paintings. So they adored her, for one thing, and I think often that is the case. You see a young child with such talent, you can't help but appreciate them as an individual. But she was cute. She's a little girl, mm-hmm. but she's painting in an amazing way, Picasso-like style.
Now, you had mentioned that they appreciated her. Well, that's a little bit of what we're talking about when we use this word adored. It's just to love someone very much, and it's especially to kind of admire them, respect them, and think very highly of them, we might say.
Right, so these people, or America, people in the art world, adored her and her Picasso-like paintings. They were a lot like the paintings that Picasso painted many years ago.
Right, so we turn this into an adjective, makes it a little more fun, Picasso-like paintings. But she didn't consider herself different from other children, it says here. And I think this is an interesting idea here. Here she is at a very young age painting in a way that most kids don't paint, and she's famous already. She's painting like Picasso, one of the most famous artists of all time, but she considers herself just like any other kid.
The innocence of children.
Yeah. Well, and when we consider ourselves, or if we consider someone else, it just means, what do we think about them, or what do we think about ourselves? And she tells us what she thinks about herself in that last sentence. It says, I'm like all other kids, except that I choose to paint in my free time. Maybe some of the other kids choose to play sports or play with dolls or do that, but she chooses to paint.
So we find out that Alexandra chooses to paint in her free time. Hey, what do you choose to do in your free time?
And now I think we should take a little time to find out what Alexandra has been doing in her free time. Let's take a look at these beautiful paintings.
Nikita's paintings attract huge crowds and evoke strong and lasting emotions. She sees angels, says Lois Regan-Zizel, director of the Tennessee State Museum. She sees spirits and she brings them into color and into life, into the world around her. What a blessing it would be if the people throughout the world could embrace the messages in this young woman's work, and if these messages could become the way we live. A true believer in the uplifting capacity of art and its ability to guide us, if we will only allow it to do so, director Regan-Zizel sees that uncommon quality in the work of Nechita.
Hi everyone, I'm Michelle. 首先一起来看的是 abstract 这个形容词。 Abstract 在这里指的是一种画风，就是抽象派的。 也就是不强调所描绘的事物实际的样子，代表的画家就是 Picasso。例如 My husband doesn't like abstract art. He thinks it's too hard to understand. 我的先生不是很欣赏抽象派艺术，他觉得太难了解了。Abstract 也是指抽象的、理论的或者是非具体的。例如 Young children have little ability for abstract thinking. 年幼的孩童还不能够做抽象的思考。Abstract 的反义字是 concrete, C-O-N-C-R-E-T-E. Concrete 就是指实际的或者是具体的。再来看的是 within 这个介系词。Within 是指在某一个范围之内，后面可以加上时间。例如 within 6 months, our company's profit has grown 20%. 在6个月之内。 我们公司的利润增加了20%。 Within的后面也可以加上空间。例如, this pass provides unlimited subway service within Tokyo City. 这张通行证提供在东京市区内无限次的地下铁服务。好,我们继续看课文。But she didn't consider herself different from other children. Consider在这里是指认为或者是当作。 课文中的 consider oneself 后面加上形容词是指认为自己如何如何。例如 Tanya never considered herself superior to others. Tanya 从来不觉得自己比别人更优越。如果是把某一个人视为或者是当作某种角色的话，是用 consider someone as something 这个动词片语。例如 the students all consider Ian as their role model. 班上所有的人都把Ian当作是他们的楷模。Well, time flies. Let's talk again tomorrow.